Hey everyone, welcome back to another Figma tutorial. Figma just dropped another update. It was probably the most requested feature. We can now add anchor links to scroll to different sections on the page. Not only that, we can also add horizontal frame targets. This is a pretty short video, so watch till the end. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon if you are interested in Figma. Let's get started. You can download this practice file and follow along. Links are in the description and comment section. To use this feature effectively, organize your file properly in frames and give proper names. Creating first anchor link is damn easy. Go to Prototype tab in the right sidebar. Select the link in menu bar. Drag from plus icon to create connection to specific section on the page. I'll connect this summary link to summary section, which is highlighted in layers panel. Click on the link to modify some properties. Here you can see brand new action called scroll to selected by default. You can now use scroll position dropdown to select or modify the position. Figma will show you all top level frames or layers. That's why organization is critical. Next, we can choose animation. I'll select animate. Easing as ease out and duration to 300 milliseconds. Preview prototype to try it out. It's working as expected, but content is getting hidden because of the fixed header. That's where offset values come into the picture. Let's go back and fix that. We have Y offset or vertical offset and X offset or horizontal offset. We have to add value similar to our header size, which is 80 pixel. Let me add Y offset as 80 plus some extra space, which is another 80 pixel, which comes as 160 pixels, and hit preview. This pushed content even further up. I expected it to work like padding values in auto layout, which adds extra spaces around. But this is entirely opposite. Here's how they have done it. Remember the coordinate system from our maths classes? Positive Y values move content upwards. If you want to move it downwards, we have to use negative offset value. The logic works same way for X axis. To push content right, use positive values. And to push content left, use negative values. I hope it's clear to you now. Let's go back and make it negative 160. Hit preview. Awesome. This is now working perfect. Connect all other sections in the same fashion. You can connect this up button to menu to take user back to top section. Hit preview to test it out. Beautiful. How easy it is to create single page websites. We no longer need to duplicate frames to simulate this. Now let's take how to use horizontal scroll or sliders. Here we have image slider with two images. Connect right arrow to second image and left arrow to first image. Preview to see if it's working. Wonderful. Even though this is a wonderful feature, I think its power is little limiting right now. For example, If you have three images here, you cannot use the same click interaction on the arrow. You have to use same number of indicators to link to specific frames, like in this example in the official Figma Playground file. But I am hopeful that with upcoming interactive component update, we can achieve that. Anyways, even without that, what we can create in just few minutes is simply amazing. I'll share a few more examples on this in upcoming videos. Hit like and comment if this was helpful. Subscribe to my channel if you are interested in Figma and design in general. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you again very soon.